intentions in mind. Oh, but wait a minute, look at this! Oh, no! Unbelievable!
Hey, this is SGU, and welcome to my WWE 2K17 My Career Series featuring superstar Matt Meyer. Now, we are on our way to Night of Champions pay-per-view. We're in week three, and we're on the SmackDown Live portion of the week. And we are taking on, once again, just like last episode, the Demon Kane. We defeated him, so we'll have to see if we can do just that once again. And see if we can find other ways to humiliate him. Oh, he's tossing us right off the bat there. Oh, maybe he's jacked up for some revenge. Let's go check out the match.
Competitors has a lot of love for the other. And that's going to become clear right about now.
Both these superstars are going to find out about themselves real quick.
Regardless, we and the rest of the WWE world are in for a night to remember. That'll put your lights out quick.
Okay, guys, I wanted to talk a little bit about Kane here. Tell us, what do you think we can anticipate seeing from him in this one?
We're going to find out a lot here tonight, head-to-head, no excuses. Let's get it on.
Yeah, he wants to send a message in this one, and that message is, I'm here to stay.
And now he goes for it a second time. The figure of Kane is intimidating beyond words. The 7-foot monster is a combination of your worst nightmares and your harshest realities in one unstoppable force of destruction. The big red monster will stop at nothing to make sure an opponent has lasting damage from a match with him, so you can never forget the name, Kane.
You know, Michael, your description of Kane may have been the most accurate broadcasting you've ever done. And that includes your days covering Operation Desert Storm. This man is known as the devil's favorite demon. I think that's all anyone needs to know.
That stop might have only lasted a second, but it's going to be felt tomorrow.
That may be felt for a lifetime.
Well, we're on the same page with this one. The trail of broken and battered bodies that Kane has left during his time in WWE is just unreal. The damage, the pain, the psychological and physical anguish Kane has inflicted on other human beings is outright sadistic. Some miscues from Kane here. Looks like he may have let his guard down there for a moment, and it cost him.
And Michael, this might very well be where one of these guys pulls away from the other.
Yeah, but he's got to remember that matches are won inside the ring, not outside.
Four. Inside the ring now.
Just think about all of the people that Kane has made suffer. I mean, superstars, announcers, executives. The big red monster doesn't care who it is. If he decides it's your time, then you will be greeted by him. Make no mistake about it, when Kane comes after you, you will need all the help you can get, and then some.
Into a quick cover is Kane.
He's showing no signs of letting up.
Seems to be running out of steam. You have to wonder if he could recover from this, guys.
Hey, it's the WWE.
It's not ballet. He knew this was going to be a battle, and that's exactly what we're witnessing.
Well, I think it's too early to call anything at this point.
I agree with you, King.
You know, we can talk all we want to about Kane's accomplishments as an individual performer.
We got a cover.
Pretty about that.
Oh, that's gonna hurt. Come on! Now he just wants that insult to injury.
Yeah, this guy's a mean streak.
You don't see that move every day. Kane's have been targeted here, and the plan of attack is working.
Yeah, this is the only type of brutality that can take Kane down. He might be injured here.
He's sending a message to the entire WWE locker room here.
No, Kane has been part of the biggest tag teams in all of WWE history. Now, if he could just get along with any of them, everyone would be in trouble.
That may be the first time we've seen that executed.
This may be turning into a brawl, King.
Yeah, just don't bring it over here.
And I think he's begging him to bring it.
I don't know how much more damage he can take.
Oh my God, I can't believe what we've seen thus far. What can possibly happen next?
Nothing. What an attack. The animosity levels of this match just continue.
Out of the way, Michael.
King, our announce table's been destroyed.
Our table? How about the guys that just went through it? Hey, one more time, just in case you missed it.
Just trying to goad his opponent into making a mistake here.
He couldn't make it.
Here's your winner, Matt Meyer.
Wow, what a match that was, ladies and gentlemen. Frankly, Kane has too much talent to be losing like this. As we close the book on this match, I need to remind everybody just how big of a win this was. Simply amazing.
So we pick up our second straight win in as many weeks against Kane on SmackDown, this time destroying him through the announce table. A couple monitors still in place and all. Could not have felt good. And Kane never does answer the bell on the 10 count. Cannot get back in the ring, and we get the victory in a 3.5-star match. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and fast forward the calendar to week 4 and see what we have going on Monday Night Raw for ourselves. The last Raw before Night of Champions. Dial this up, and it is against our rival, Luke Gallows of the Club. And again, it's a one-on-one match. No tag team action. However, our tag team partner, Jaden Jett, is taking on the other half of the club, Carl Anderson. Let's go check it out.
King, this match has been building for weeks and weeks and finally comes to a culmination tonight.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. What's this?
What is he doing out here?
Well, it looks...
He has no business coming out here.
Well, it looks like we're going to have a guest here at ringside.
I mean, seriously, King, he has no reason to be out here.
Well, look, it doesn't look like he's going to interfere in the match. There's no problem here.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure he's out here just to watch as a fan. Please, you know this guy's history.
Have a seat. Join us here at ringside. You got a great bird's eye view.
Okay, so Meyer is ringside, possibly for some insurance, and this match is underway. And just a little while later...
Well, there he goes. Into that turnbuckle, hard and... Oh, look, we knew this was going to happen, Cole.
Yeah, but let's not forget, there's still a match going on in the ring, but...
Uh-oh.
I knew it, King. I agree with you. We knew this was... It was only a matter of time before this thing just blew up.
Well, there's a match in the ring, but we may have a match out here. Whoa,
that's what I was afraid of. The distraction and then the shot.
We provide the distraction, helping out Jaden Jett, but what happens next is a little unexpected. This is just a one-on-one normal match. Why are they allowing this to be two-on-one? And by the way, I'm not controlling my character whatsoever right now, so this is completely up to the AI. But why are they letting this be a two-on-one match? No disqualification. It ends up with Jaden Jett getting the pin. 1, 2, and 3. And then more importantly, where is Luke Gallows in all this? Why does he not come out to defend his tag team partner? That seems like a very sticky situation for members of the club here, as he was left out to dry. And Jaden Jett gets the victory. So now on to our match against Luke Gallows. Will there be any shenanigans going on in this one? Or it'll be straight up 1 versus 1? I guess we'll have to find out as we go to the ring right now.
You can feel the electricity running through this arena. This is going to be some battle, one-on-one, mano-a-mano.
With these competitors, this should be amazing.
And the party has officially begun.
Two.
But hey, there hasn't been a time that I've sat in this chair and not been excited. So, I guess I'm a little biased.
He's too good inside the ring to be out on the floor for long.
Here we go, back inside the ring. Let's talk briefly about Myers. You have to respect the way he goes about his business. He's all about getting the W, and fans seem to love him for that.
Well, we're going to find out who's the better competitor, that's for sure. No gimmicks here, just some good old-fashioned one-on-one action.
You know, whether they admit it or not, I think this is the type of admiration every competitor dreams of when they get into this business.
And he gets out of the ring, stopping this assault for the moment.
Oh, look at the emotion.
Careful what you wish for. It can get real ugly outside the ring.
And these guys are real ugly.
Two.
This guy's just getting worn out.
Absolutely relentless here.
Oh, I think this man needs business. This might be it.
I'm not sure if he knows where he is right now.
Well, that missed him all right.
Hey, did you look before firing? What an idiot.
Clearly on a mission here.
Authority.
Man, he hit hard.
A stiff shot with the elbow.
Out here, King, you can use this whole ringside area as a weapon.
Oh, yeah. Everything from the floor to the barricades can and will be used to inflict pain. Oh, no!
Oh! How will these guys do with absorbing the punishment they're about to receive out here? He's on the defensive here. With these two guys, we all knew this was going to be an all-out battle.
But Michael, he's looked so good throughout this entire match. I don't expect this to be very much of a setback for him.
You said it, John. And I'm a little surprised he spent so much time outside the ring thus far.
He doesn't want to win this one outside the ring.
Because he's a pro, King. He wants to get it done inside.
Luke Gallows is going in for the kill.
Can he score the pin?
One, two, three.
And that's the match.
Here's your winner.
Absolutely amazing. We knew he felt he had to win this tonight. I mean, there's absolutely no way to underscore how big this victory is, perhaps the biggest in his career.
I gotta agree with you, Cole, the biggest in his career.
That's the kind of win that makes you feel good about yourself.
Guys, it sounds like we can all agree that was an extremely impressive win.
Well, okay then. Luke Gallows gets the best of Matt Meyer here on Raw. We're moving on to SmackDown. And actually, he has swayed the rivalry points in his favor. We're now at a -8, but ooh, look at this. I get really excited whenever there's anything but a normal match stipulation. And we've got a fatal four-way coming up on SmackDown. Before this came up, I'm like, do I just kind of fast forward through SmackDown, get to Night of Champions? No. We are definitely playing this fatal four-way. It's going to be Dolph Ziggler, Matt Meyer, The Big Show, and Randy Orton. Can't wait to get some chair shots in here, use some objects. Fatal four-way is going to be a lot of fun, and I can't wait. SmackDown and then Night of Champions. We'll see you guys next time.